So how do you get started? First, you need a business. Then you need to get registered. If you already have a business, you're halfway there. The government needs everything: batteries, lights, plumbing, mechanical, roofing, everything. We are their Target, their Walmart, small businesses are. If you can think of it, they need it. But you need a business first. Do your research on proprietorship, LLC, C corporation, chapter S's, and things like that. Once you register your company with the Secretary of State, the Secretary of State are going to provide you with an EIN number. Once you get that Articles of Incorporation with that EIN number on there, then you input that information into SAM.gov. So you're going to register into SAM.gov under the Entity Registration tab. You're going to put in your EIN number, which is going to define your company. They're going to track your company via Secretary of State. Once you go through the registration process of SAM.gov, they're going to issue you out a unique entity identifier, which is considered a UEI number. And you're going to also receive a CAGE code from SAM.gov. This UEI number is very comparable to your state EIN number, but it's for the federal government. This is how they track all your transactions. This is how they track your company past performances. It will be tied to every contract, every offer you have for the federal government, your UEI number and your CAGE code. Now it's time to package your capability statement. A capability statement is your business resume. A capability statement is a brief description of all of your offerings. It's a one-page description of your company umbrella. It's that curb appeal, that first look, that introduction. You want to make sure that your capability statement is professional. You might only get that one chance. Your capability statement spells out everything: your company name, your company information. It has your primary NAICS codes, your secondary NAICS codes, your UEI and your CAGE codes, and your product service codes. This is how the federal government finds you. You may be in the laundry service and your next code might be something that represents laundry. You may be a roofing supplier. That is how the government is going to identify you based on that service code, that NAICS code, that NAICS code. Make sure that you have your NAICS codes and secondary NAICS codes inputted into your SAM profile and on your capability statement, so you can be on the forefront of their mind when they are doing their market research trying to find suppliers for the upcoming opportunities they have. Your primary NAICS code is what you do best. It's your everyday thing. Your secondary NAICS codes are other things that you can do that you still want to participate in, that you still want to bid on. Let's say you're a new company and you don't have any past performance, but you qualify for set aside. Set asides allow you to compete in certain arenas where you may be at a disadvantage. The federal government set aside 23 to 30% of spending for diverse contractors. Diverse contractors are considered woman-owned, disadvantaged woman-owned, HUB-zoned, service-disabled veterans, veteran-owned small businesses, and 8A disadvantaged businesses, companies that are certified through the SBA program. These set-asides would allow you to participate in this space and only compete amongst your peers versus competing against everybody else in the United States. If you fall into this bracket, I suggest taking the documentation that you have already available, since you have it already together, to go to sba.gov and see if you qualify and register for those set-asides. Now you're registered. You're registered in SAM.gov. You have your UEI number. You have your CAGE code. You have your NAICS codes, your secondary NAICS codes. You have your capability statements. You have your certifications. You are ready to participate in this federal contracting space. Now, your environment matters. Now, you need to become visible. You need to do your research on industry days. You need to get involved with events. You need to reach out to your local PTAC personnel and see what upcoming events do they have in the area that fits your profile, your set asides, your NAICS codes. Get involved, go in and shake hands. It's sort of like going to school for the first time and you're going into an arena end users and they have their booth set up and they're looking for you. They're looking for people like you. They want to hear about your offerings. They want your capability statement. Remember, your capability statement is golden. It's your invitation into the party. Make sure you have that curb appeal. Make sure you have your capability statement dressed up. So when you go to these industry days, you're going to go and you're going to shake hands with prime vendors, subcontractors, other vendors like yourself that you could potentially partner with. You're going to get out, introduce yourself. I remember my first day of school and it would be a new school and I wouldn't know anybody. This is going to be that same kind of feeling, that same environment. I just left an event in Dallas, Texas this weekend, and at heart, I'm an introvert and I spend most days quiet. But when I went to this event this weekend, I found myself in a room full of entrepreneurs. I was really quiet. I really didn't know how. I was having that same feeling that I'm explaining to you right now that you're going to have when you attend these industry days. And I had a chance to pitch my shot to somebody. And I was like, yeah, my name Derrick Surratt. And I didn't really know how to pitch it. I should have just came directly and said, hey, my name Derrick Surratt. How you doing? This is what I do. So I understand sometimes it just doesn't come out that way. I'm going to challenge you to work on that pitch, work on that introduction, work on that handshake, smile, and pitch your capabilities, because can't nobody do what you do like you do. People don't have the same relationships that you have. You are the only one that can do what you do. So go to industry days, get involved, go to SBA subnet, see what the prime vendors have to offer. Go to SAM.gov, look at the pre-solicitations, look at the sources sought, special notices, look at all of the free tools available, and ask the right questions. I promise you, if you have the question, somebody else have the question. Once you get into this mode, come back and check us out on the YouTube channel, ask more questions, and together we rise. Like and subscribe today.